The plot thickens, the mystery expands. Hello and welcome to the next episode of our true crime podcast, The Only Murders in the Building, not The Room. I noticed that mistake last time now. I know the mistake. So it's Only Murders in the Building. Today we're going to be reviewing episodes 3 and 4. So far I've only watched the third one. But I'll be going to watch that after the third one. So this third one was pretty decent. It wasn't as good as the last one, but I think it did do justice. We will be going a little more spoiler heavy. I think you're allowed to watch the first episode, and I'm like, okay, you can. I'll try to avoid spoilers. But now I'm actually gonna go spoiler heavy, because you should be watching these episodes before you watch reviews. If I'm being honest, that's just my personal preference, and that's how I'm gonna do it. So, spoilers ahead. I think it's a decent episode. Before we get ahead of ourselves, if you want to avoid spoilers, all I'll say is it was decent, and then skip to this time code to see what I think of the fourth episode. But yeah, it was a decent episode. I liked the way they delved into Oliver Putnam's character, aka Martin Short's character. He's the only character that I know the character like Mabel, and the person who he played a character named Brazos. That's all I know about a freaking Steve Martin's character. But yeah, it was a pretty decent episode. We searched some suspects, and we might have a potential person who was responsible, because he nearly killed a dog, which, you know, that's a low blow. You know. Why would you do that? Why would you do that? It's just like, why would I? How dare you? How dare you?
How dare you?
But seriously though, like, just like, that's a low blow. Like, all because the dog was messing with you, bro. It's kind of sus. It's kind of sus, bro. So yeah, it was a pretty decent episode. We delved a little bit more into, obviously, Martin Short's character. Got some flashbacks about the way he's play live. And then we learned about something called Splash, a musical that went terribly wrong, where he got, like, 12 people injured. And he lost so much money, and he used his own son's college fund. Like, that's kind of sad, you know? But I enjoyed the episode. I think there's some creativity in there, like with the stage thing where, like, all the suspects in one line. It's not what actually happened, but, like, it was fun just to see that. There's some good jokes, like the duck joke, if you understand what I mean there. It was pretty fun, I must say. I think that's my thoughts on episode 3. And we'll move on to episode 4. Skip to this little time code right here.
Want me to leave?
No, I want to solve this murder, so catch me up.
All right. Sting is on the run. I heard from Ursula. He has moved his rainforest tour up and is leaving in 2 days. Suspicious. Also, he's renovating his apartment when he's gone, because apparently he wants a fresh start. I bet he does, right? Anyway, Mabel has plans in the afternoon, so that only leaves tomorrow morning. And, you know, at 20 minutes a pound.
So we're gonna bring Sting a morning turkey?
Yeah, I know, it's weird. But I figure if we also brought coffee.
Alright, and we're here at episode 4 of Only Murders in the Building, and this episode was pretty good. I actually liked the little deep dive here. I said spoiler heavy. I liked the deep dive with our character today. That was pretty fun, honestly. With Steve Martin, but the Brazos character, I liked that. I liked the date. The love interest wasn't weird, because I think she looked as old. I liked the bassoon girl. That was nice. She was established in the last episode, but we're like, we're comparing it now. The Looney Tunes was kind of weird, and I will say there's one gripe here. It's that Sting was very cringe when he started singing about it. But there were definitely some funny moments. We ran into a dead end. He's like, yeah, I killed him. I pushed him to kill him. So, you know, like, dang it. What if it's actually revealed that, it, like, they're trying to prove that he wasn't killed, didn't kill himself. But, like, and he probably did. But, like, we're still trying to figure it out and get a Sting cameo. Because why not? You know? Because why not? So, yeah, it was a good episode. I think my ranking of the episode so far is 2, 3, 1, 4. Oh, no, not 4. 4, 1. Actually, no. You know, 1-4. I think this one's it's still a good episode, don't get me wrong, but I think it wasn't as crazy as the other ones, but I do enjoy, by the way, that's probably just check that rating out the window. It just fluctuates for me. I have my issues with 1 and 4, but I don't have issues with the other two, really. So, like, the Sting little singing was a bit cringe, and, the Looney Tunes showing up thing was a little random. It was explained at the end, so I then understood why we were suddenly getting Bugs Bunny and all those just, like, in costumes and, like, looking weird, like they're about to go murder him and it's about to start turn into a horror movie. I'm like, ah! But, but, yeah, just... Yeah, just that's what I think. It was an okay episode, okay to decent episode. I quite enjoyed it. So yeah, if you enjoyed, this review of these episodes 3 and 4, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe, comment what you thought of the episode. If you've seen them, you should have seen them. On Instagram, be sure to like, the comment, follow, maybe post, put it on your story. Who knows? Comment with your thoughts. I don't know. I'm chucking things at this point. But yeah, that was my review of the episodes 3 and 4 of The Only Murders in the Building. And I will see you next time, because probably the next video will be the review of that.